Hey guys, welcome to the channel. This week we are doing the next one up in the Pokerap, which is Mankey.
We gotta rap some Pokemon.
You just do the singing. I'll take care of the hard part.
Let's get it on.
All right, so here we are. We're gonna start off with the background. Last week we did Nidoran, and they were on the forest floor. So this one's gonna be up in the forest treetops, and we're gonna have Mankey hanging from the branch up front here. And I knew straight away that I was going to turn him upside down. I wasn't quite sure how I was going to attach him to that branch, but that became evident pretty quickly. And right now I'm not worried at all about anatomy, just laying down the initial shapes and trying to get him situated in the piece, figuring out how much he's going to take up of the image. This is just about getting those colors down, those local colors, the shapes, and not really worrying about anatomy. And to be honest, with a design like Mankey's, you don't have to worry too much about anatomy anyway. He is a big ball with a few limbs sticking out of him. The most detail that we're really going to see is in that tiny little face that he's got, just the eyes and that nose, and then the fur. But then this piece is much more indicative of what I usually do, my usual process, putting down line work. Usually I put down about three different layers of lines, and I knock them back and go over the top with cleaner lines. Didn't have to go through that much of a process with this one. It is kind of a messy design. Have plenty of layers on him already anyway. And after any kind of line work, I put in the shadows. Whether that's with a multiply layer or just change up in values. Sometimes I only paint on one layer. This one, of course, is on multiple layers, so I'm using a few multiply layers, and then it helps define where the shapes are and where they end, where they begin. Especially when it comes to fur and it's a similar texture all the way around, those values are really important when you're building your piece. And I'm using the DG main brush for pretty much everything here. It's the DG main from Dave Greco. You can use it for pretty much anything, and right now I've got it very small, putting layers on top of layers for all this fur. Later in this piece, I'll end up using Aaron Blaise's directional hair brushes. The directional hair brushes are awesome, and they look really realistic, but with any kind of digital trickery that you're using on Photoshop or anything like that, you've got to have the foundations down first. I can't just rely on that completely, otherwise it just won't look right. And it does take some time. Getting in every one of these little lines, it does take some time, but I find it pretty soothing, actually, that you can kind of just get lost in this part. And you just keep building every layer, so the darker layers underneath, and then you get lighter and lighter while you keep in mind where that light source is coming from and try to build the form from there. But I had a lot of fun with this part right here, creating those little sort of triangular tufts and shapes, and he's got this kind of mustache thing going. I don't know what it is with the last couple of Pokemon that really, they don't have mouths. You can't really see their mouths. Diglett didn't have one. Mankey doesn't have one. Probably have to go back in the anime and check to see if there's any time where he's opening his mouth and screaming or something. I don't even think Primeape does, and he screams a lot, but he's usually just got that angry little vein thing in his head. So here I'm almost done with that first layer of all the fur, and then I've got to get into the background. So I've got to a point where I've got to start building the background and matching the level of detail. Even though I do like combining styles, sometimes I like to mix between, high resolution sort of detail and more painterly styles. But I'd never really know that until I start working on the piece. And when I'm about halfway through, maybe 60% done with the character, I like to go back into the background and figure out what that is going to look like as well. And here's something a little fun. This was a total experiment with this leaf I'm drawing here. So I drew it in, and then, as you can see, I duplicated it and duplicated it, and just used it to create the foliage around the scene here. And again, you can't just expect it to do it for you. You still have to think about, like, depth. So the background is obviously going to be lighter, more atmosphere coming in, and it's more affected by that skylight coming through. And then the ones in front are going to be darker. So I use a multiply layer for that. And in fact, I used a couple of different multiply layers and experimented quite a bit with the lighting scenario here. I was trying a bit of dappled light. This first bit, it didn't work. I didn't like it at all. So when I was going back over with the textured brushes, I got rid of it just to figure out where I was going to place everything. The funny thing about Aaron Blaise's brushes is that they come across really quite realistic if you do it right, and you've got to make sure that carries through for the rest of the image, like his eyes and his nose. That's pretty much it, guys, for this week. Thank you so much for watching. Next week we've got Venusaur. I'm really excited about that one. Venusaur happens to be one of my favorite Pokemon. He's not just his design, which I do love, but he was one of my first choices. I know he wasn't always the popular choice of the first three starters, but once I learned how to use the poison types and the grass types, he was one of my, well, he's still one of my first picks for any game. So I'll see you next week. Thanks so much for watching.
Catch 'em all.